السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وجوثه إن شاء الله تعالى سورة المجادلة، سورة number 58 and verses 5 and 6. verses 5 and 6 from سورة المجادلة. verses 5 and 6 from سورة المجادلة. So open your Mus'haf inshallah and read after me. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الذين يحادون الله ورسوله كبتوا. كبتوا كما كبت الذين من قبلهم وقد أنزلنا آيات بينات وللكافرين عذاب يوم يبعثهم الله جميعا فينبئهم بما عملوا أحصاه الله ونسوه والله على كل شيء شهيد إن الذين يحادون إن with نون with شدة takes two counts الذين يحادون six counts like يتماس like ولا الضالين so the مد is the longest one six counts يحادون الله ورسوله كبتوا كما كبت الذين من قبلهم إخفاء من قبلهم وقد أنزلنا four to five counts and before that is إخفاء أنزلنا آيات بينات the تنوين after it باء and you see the meme, the small meme وللكافرين عذاب تنوين after it meme إضغام عذاب مهين يوم يبعثهم الله جميعا يب the باء is with سكون قلقلة يوم يبعثهم الله جميعا فينبئهم بما عملوا ميم after it but this is إخفاء أحصاه الله ونسوه the همزة is light and the حاء is light and the صاد is heavy أحصاه أحصاه الله ونسوه والله على كل شيء شهيد إخفاء والله على كل شيء شهيد the translation of the verses indeed those who oppose Allah and his messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم are abased as those before them were abased And we have certainly sent down verses of clear evidence, and for the disbelievers is a humiliating punishment. On the day when Allah will resurrect them all and inform them of what they did. Allah had enumerated it while they forgot it, and Allah is over all things witness. So hear this ayah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحَدُّونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ That those who oppose Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-muhadda is to disobey, to oppose, but mainly it's used for something huge, not in minor issues, but in matters of disbelief, in opposing the deen of Allah, objecting the commands of Allah, having and showing enmity towards the believers. You know, so this is usually the word al-muhadda is used for this. With the major matters. So those who oppose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and oppose the deen of Allah and in a war against the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُبِتُوا كَمَا كُبِتَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ That means they are abased, they are humiliated, they will be punished, a severe punishment like those who before them. And the kept kobi too is when someone is crunched is or crushed. I'm sorry, someone is oppressed in a humiliating way. And this is a word that the people use when they say someone has kept someone that is, has so much pressure inside. So it's from if it's from someone else, I mean, someone is crushing someone. Someone is humiliating him. So kubitu, that means this is what's going to happen to them. They will be crushed with humiliation, with punishment, severe punishment for them as a result of their muhadda, their objecting, opposing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that will happen to them kama kubita alladhina min qablihim, the same way as those who before them, what happened to them, they were punished and humiliated as a just recompense and punishment from Allah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means they have no excuse whatsoever because the matter has been explained to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed clear ayat, warnings, and calling them, inviting them to the truth. And therefore, wa lil kafirin adhabun muhin, and to the disbelievers is a humiliating punishment because they were arrogantly turning away from the commands of Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humiliated them. And this ayah came after what's mentioned of in the previous verses from the surah with when it comes to limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is mentioned with regards to al-dhihar. So to show that those who oppose the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if as the ulama they said with regards to the people, the munafiqeen in al-Madinah, or those who would ridicule the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and disbelieve in the orders of Allah, this is what happens to them. كُبِتُوا كَمَا كُبِتَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَدَ أَنزَلْنَا آيَاتٍ بَيْنَةٍ. We brought down clear ayat. So whoever turns away from it, they should not blame anyone but their own selves. وَالْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. The next ayah, يَوْمَا يَبْعَثُهُمُ اللَّهُ جَمِيعًا. And the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will resurrect them, all of them, none will be left. And they will be resurrected, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, سَرِيعًا, in haste, quickly. يَوْمَا يَبْعَثُهُمُ اللَّهُ جَمِيعًا. No one will be delayed. فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا. And he would inform them of what they did. The disbelievers, the hypocrites, the evil ones, and also everyone, the righteous ones, also would get to know what they did. فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا, from good or evil. Because this is in the knowledge of Allah, and it's written, recorded, and the angels recorded that against them or for them. أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ وَنَسُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أَحْصَاهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enumerated it. It's all collected, registered, written. It's not going to be, forgotten, or the records will be lost. Like the human beings, maybe this happens to them, but to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything is recorded. أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ وَنَسُوا, and they forgot it. We forget what we did yesterday and the day before and so on. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forget. What we did is recorded, and it's either going to be on one side in the day of judgment or against them. وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all witness over all things, the apparent things and the hidden things, and openly and the secretly, and the major and the minor, everything. That the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything. So the ayah brings the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that the person has to be watchful. And other benefits, of course, by the mercy of Allah, and one of which is like the issue is of أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ وَنَسُوا. The wrongdoers, they should not think that since their life continued to be as good as it was or even better, the more they disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a bad sign for them because everything is recorded. And for those who were oppressed and wronged against and so on, they should be patient and they should remember that everything is recorded. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. And no injustice whatsoever would prevail or would have the upper hand at the end. There is no way this is going to happen. Either a person who gets his right in this life, or if it's not, then in the hereafter, and the hereafter is best for the righteous ones, and it's the worst for the wrongdoers. If something is delayed to the day of judgment, it's worse. Because when a person is afflicted by difficult things in this life or punishment in this life, it purifies the person in the hereafter. But a person, if he wronged himself or wronged others, he can repent to Allah, so there's no harm then in this life or in the hereafter. But the more the person do evil, and the more he's left and he's enjoying his life, this is even a worse sign for him. And أحصاه الله ونسوه, we should also care about the things that we forgot of bad deeds and sins in our life. And this is, has some rulings with regarding to it. If, for example, a person did not pay zakah before in certain years and he was supposed to pay zakah, but he didn't, but he doesn't remember exactly how much. He doesn't remember how many years that he did not do that. He still has to do the best of his ability in this. You know, and for example, if he's not sure if it's 3 years or 5 years, then he makes it 5 years. If he's not sure how much wealth, he has to estimate. He has to go back and think, look at records, whatever there is, but he has to do the best of his ability to do so. So these are the things that has expiations or things that has to give in salah missed or whatever there is. And the things that a person forgets and he doesn't really remember, words of mouth, something that here or there, then we have to have a general tawbah always to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all of the sins, what we know and what we don't know. And this is from the dua of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, many dua of the Prophet sallam, Allahumma aghfir li ma qaddamtu ma akhartu ma asartu ma alantu wa anta a'lamu bihi minni. Allah forgive the future, the back, the past, what I know and what I do not know. You know, these types of things for the person to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are the two verses here. When we look at the verses and the words of it, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحَادُّونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. Then you said al-muhadda from ha dal dal, and that's as you see the root of it from hadad or al-had, right? And the hudud of Allah is mentioned before, the limits of Allah. So they transgress the limits. So as if it's related here, those who oppose the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such an evil way. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحَدُّونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ كُبِتُوا from كَبَتَ. And as we said, the meaning of it is humiliated and so on. And it comes from being crushed and humiliated. And also it's a word that is used when someone has so much miseries in mentally or in his heart. You know, all of that is used for this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لِيَقَطَعَ طَرَفًا مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَوْ يَكْبِتَهُمْ فَيَنْقَلِبُوا خَائِبِينَ. Disgraced, suppressed, like this. كُبِتُوا كَمَا كُبِتَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. The same way that those who before them were كُبِتُوا, the same way. وَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ. And we brought down آيَات, أَنزَلْنَا from نَزَلَ, آيَات, the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And ayat is the plural of ayah, comes from alif ya, ya. Bayanat, clear, from ba ya noon, wal kafirina adhabun muheen, and to the disbelievers from kafara, adhab, punishment from ayn dhal ba, muheen, humiliated, or humiliating punishment. Humiliating punishment from waw ha noon. And then the next ayah, yawma yab'athuhum, on the day when yab'athuhum, he would raise them from ba'atha. يَوْمَ يَبْعَثُهُمُ اللَّهُ جَمِيعًا. Resurrect them, all جَمِيعًا, all of them. فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ. Then he will inform them. فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ. They, he would inform them from نَبَأ. بِمَا عَمِلُوا, with what they did. أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ. أَحْصَاهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recorded, enumerated it from حَا صَاد يَا. And that إحصاء is the same word that they use for statistics nowadays. They use the word الإحصاء to encompass everything. And the hadith in the latest hadith, man ahsaha dakhal jannah. To Allah is 99 names, whoever ahsaha, whoever had it comprehended, memorized it, recorded, right? Ahsaynahu wa kull shay'in ahsaynahu fi imamin mubin. Everything is registered, everything is accounted for, nothing is missed or lost or so. Ahsahu Allah wa nasu, and they nasu, they forgot it, from Nun Sa Sinin. Yeah. Wallahu ala kulli shayin shaheed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon all things shaheed. That means He is subhanahu wa ta'ala a witness over all things. And everything is easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll stop here inshallah ta'ala at this. And as you see, the ayat is limits that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set for the people. And he made what's halal, halal, what's haram, haram. And the people, they are to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and submit themselves to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and warning against those who would oppose the deen of Allah, and they will be oppressed, they will be humiliated, they will be punished. So therefore, a call to the believers, لا يغرنك تقلب الذين كفروا في البلاد. Do not be deceived by the ways of the disbelievers on the land. They live on the land as if they have full control of it. They decide and they fulfill what they decide, and they plot, and their plot is successful of evil and so on. So don't be deceived by this, because this is all part of the test. Iblis, and from the very beginning, when he refused to make sujood to Adam alayhi salam, this is an enmity and a war that is a continuous one, started in the heavens when Iblis refused to prostrate to Adam alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Kunna habitu minha jami'an ba'dukum li ba'din adu." We said to descend all of you to this earth, you will be enemies to one another. So enemies, that means they're in a constant war with Iblis, Shaitan, and the helpers of Iblis. So who is going to be firm upon the commands of Allah versus those who are defeated by Iblis and the enemies of Iblis? And one of which is, when those who have weak iman, they become overpowered or overwhelmed by the power of the disbelievers, of the evildoers, so they end up following them and turning away from the deen of Allah. This is all a sign of weak iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum. We'll stop here, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our gatherings and make it for the sake of Allah. And we continue, inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow with more, inshallah. Actually, after tomorrow, since Jumu'ah, well, there's no classes on Jumu'ah, inshallah. May Allah bless the night of Jumu'ah for everyone and the day of Jumu'ah, and to make us fulfill the rites of Jumu'ah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammad wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.